One of the richest men of all time won't be found on any rich people lists because, well, he was a hardened murderous criminal drug lord. That would be Pablo Escobar, the undisputed king of cocaine from the late 70s to the early 90s. His coke smuggling ring made him rich beyond measure, and even though his money was ill-gotten and his product ruined countless lives, it's still impressive that he managed to accumulate such ridiculous wealth in such a short period of time. At Escobar's peak in 1992, he was worth an incredible $30 billion. That number made him the second richest man on the planet, behind only the Sultan of Brunei. Translated into today's money, he would be worth around $58 billion, enough to make him the 8th richest man on Earth were he active today. Even if he were only worth $30 billion today, he would still rank in the top 30. He obviously didn't make this money by selling coke on the streets by himself. He ran the Medellin Cartel, a Colombian drug ring that quickly rose to rule the cocaine world. At their largest, they controlled up to 90% of the US's cocaine and up to 80% of the global stash. It's no exaggeration to say that if you or someone you know was ever addicted to coke, it was probably because of Pablo Escobar. Thanks, you smug jerk. The cartel did this by smuggling an unbelievable amount of drugs. They owned an island in the Bahamas where large planes that smuggled cocaine from Colombia would land to refuel. While doing so, they would hand off the cocaine to smaller planes, which would fly to the US and put the white gold out in the streets. They did this 5 to 7 times a day at their peak. All in all, the Medellin cartel smuggled up to 15 tons of cocaine into the US each day. That's 30,000 pounds of coke 365 times over. To compare, a 2015 California cocaine bust yielded 9 tons of coke worth $200 million. Imagine that, almost doubled every single day for well over a decade. That's an unfathomable amount of money. Indeed, the cartel made up to $60 million a day from their work, since a kilo of coke could sell for upwards of $70,000 on the streets. Meanwhile, it only cost the cartel $5,000 to refine and smuggle each kilo into the states. Even paying their pilots up to $500,000 per flight didn't affect their bottom line. That's because their bottom line was massive. $60 million a day equaled an astronomical $22 billion a year in company revenue. And unlike most multi-billion dollar companies, whose wealth is mostly tied up in stocks and investments, the Medellin cartel boasted billions of dollars per year in cold, hard cash. If they turned it all into gold coins, they could have easily swam in it like Scrooge McDuck. That kind of annual revenue would be enough to place the Medellin cartel high on the Fortune 500, assuming Fortune magazine got into the business of honoring criminal organizations. If they did, Medellin would rank around 140, pulling in more money per year than giants like Visa, Netflix, General Mills, Office Depot, Motorola, Harley-Davidson, and even McDonald's. Sorry, Ronald, you're just gonna have to sell more burgers. The cartel had so much money lying around, they spent $1,000 a day in rubber bands to organize the cash into wads. Think of that, $1,000 per day on rubber bands. Do you know what the typical person spends $1,000 a day on? Nothing, because that kind of spending is insane. They spent $365,000 per year on those bands, almost as much as the President of the United States' $400,000 annual salary. The cartel accumulated so much cash, they had no place to store it all. They couldn't deposit their billions of illegal dollars into a bank without setting off alarms, so they had to find other solutions. They wound up stashing much of it in old warehouses, while other bills wound up buried in fields. Roughly 10% of that money did not survive, being lost forever to water and other elements, ruining them beyond use. If not that, rats would simply chew the dough to shreds. That's $2.2 billion in cash written off for good every single year. With $2.2 billion, you could buy both the Miami Marlins and the New Orleans Pelicans, and still have $2 million left over to buy a 15-acre island in the Florida Keys. Pablo Escobar, meanwhile, reacted to $2 billion in annual losses with a resounding, so what? The man was still insanely rich, having far more money than he could ever spend in his lifetime. This is a man who once lit a fire with $2 million in cash because his daughter was cold. To a mega billionaire, that was nothing. $2 million was literally 1/15,000th of his fortune. That's like if you had $150 in your bank account and dropped a penny into a fountain just because you felt like it. $30 billion in wealth is nearly impossible for our brains to fathom. So look at it this way. You would have to win the grand prize on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire 30,000 times and save every penny of your winnings to equal Escobar's fortune. Only you still couldn't match him because you would pay taxes on your winnings, something Escobar certainly didn't bother doing. Argentinian soccer player Lionel Messi was the highest paid athlete of 2019, earning an incredible $127 million in salary and endorsements. That's incredible, and yet he would need to earn that much every year for 236 years and 3 months to equal Escobar's nest egg. The US federal minimum wage is $7.25 an hour. To make $30 billion, a minimum wage worker would need to work 4,155,124,653.75 hours. Assuming a 40-hour work week, that would take 519,390,582 days, or just under 1,422,988 years. Escobar, meanwhile, earned that much in 16 years. His wealth was nearly beyond imagination, but it came at an incredible cost. The Medellin cartel murdered thousands of people and ruined untold millions of lives with their product. Plus, all that money didn't save Pablo Escobar himself from an early, violent death. On December 2, 1993, Colombian police gunned him down, and with him went the Medellin cartel. While we'd love to say that police confiscated his and his company's money, that is simply not the case. Virtually all of Pablo Escobar's fortune remains missing to this day, stashed in various well-hidden locales around the world. If Lara Croft were real, we'd order her to stop tomb raiding and instead search shacks and shallow graves for wads of cash. But she's not, so we're currently stuck not knowing where the money is. The sad fact is, even if we find the money, most of it is likely unsalvageable due to decades of elemental damage. It's also possible the cartel, knowing their time was up, went to their secret hiding places and burnt the piles of money like the Joker. Whatever happened to the money, it's currently not in circulation. Thanks to Pablo Escobar and his Medellin cartel, the world is untold billions of dollars poorer. So the next time you wonder why the world's economy isn't as good as it should be, or why we don't have as strong a middle class anymore, don't just blame major corporations. Blame Pablo.